In this video, I am going to explain material science, which comes under module 5 of VTA syllabus. Here I am going to discuss expression for Fermi energy, merits of quantum free electron theory, expression for electrical conductivity in semiconductors, electron and hole concentration, and also Fermi energy in semiconductors. Now, expression for Fermi energy. According to Fermi-Dirac theory, the total number of conduction electrons per unit energy range per unit volume is given by n of e is equal to integration 0 to infinity g of e dE f of e. So if you calculate, the value becomes integration 0 to infinity. So we have to substitute the corresponding values. So 8 root 2 pi m to the power of 3 by 2 by h cube into it is for f of dE. Okay. At 0 Kelvin, the top of the electron energy distribution is defined as F. So the integral becomes N is equal to 8 root 2 pi m to the power of 3 by 2 whole divided by h cube into integration 0 to F, it is for half of dE. So after simplification and after rearranging the terms, we get EF is equal to h square by 8m into 3n by pi whole to the power of 2 by 3. This is what the expression for Fermi energy. Next, expression for electrical conductivity in metals. According to Sommerfeld, quantum free electron theory, the free electrons obey Fermi-Dirac statistics by applying Fermi-Dirac statistics and by using the Boltzmann's transport equation. The expression for electrical conductivity is given by sigma is equal to Ne square lambda by m star Vf. Here, m star is the effective mass of the electron. Next, merits of quantum free electron theory or success of quantum free electron theory. So, let us take up the first case specific it. According to classical free electron theory, all the free electrons in a metal absorb the heat energy when a metal is heated. It results in a large value of specific heat. But as per quantum free electron theory, only a few electrons that are occupying energy level close to the Fermi energy level, that is EF, absorbs the heat energy to get excited and go to higher energy levels and contribute for specific heat. Hence, the value of specific heat is observed to be very small. According to quantum free electron theory, the specific heat of solid is given by Cv is equal to 2k by EF into RT. So, the value of 2k by EF is approximately equal to 10 to the power of minus 4. So, the value becomes 10 to the power of minus 4 RT. By taking EF is equal to 5 electron volts, as EF varies between 1 to 10 electron volt for all metals, the above results agrees well with the experimentally observed values. The second one is temperature dependence of electrical conductivity. As per quantum free electron theory, the electrical conductivity for metals is given by sigma is equal to Ne square lambda by m star Vf. Consider that as equation number 1. Also, as per the theory, EF and VF are essentially independent of temperature and lambda is proportional to temperature, as is explained as follows. As the free electron travels in a metal, they get scattered by vibrating ions of the lattice. The vibrations occur in such a way that the displacement of ions takes place equally in all directions. Hence, ions may be assumed to be present effectively in a circular cross-section of area pi r square, which blocks the path of the electrons irrespective of direction of approach. So here r is the amplitude of vibration. The vibrations of larger area of cross-section scatter more effectively, thereby reducing lambda. Therefore, lambda is inversely proportional to pi r square. So, consider that as equation number 2. But the energy E of the vibrating body is proportional to the square of amplitude, and E is due to thermal energy, and the last one is E is proportional to temperature T. Therefore, here we can consider R square is proportional to T and lambda is proportional to 1 by T. So, comparing 1 and the equation number 3, we get sigma is proportional to 1 by T. Thus, dependence of conductivity on temperature is correctly explained. The third one is electrical conductivity and electron concentration. As per quantum free electron theory, sigma is equal to n square lambda by n star Vf. Thus, conductivity depends both on n and also lambda by Vf and m star. If we compare the case of copper and aluminum, the value of n for aluminum is 2.13 times higher than that of copper, but the value of lambda by Vf for copper is 3.73 times greater than that of aluminum. Thus, the conductivity of copper is greater than conductivity of aluminum, that is sigma Cu is greater than sigma Al. Also, m star for aluminum is 1.08 times greater than that of copper. Due to inverse dependence of sigma on m star, thus the conductivity of aluminum is less than that of copper. Next, let us look at the physics of semiconductors. Here we come across diagrams indicating energy level diagram for metals, semiconductors and insulators. And for metal, it is observed that electrons are already exist in conduction band, whereas in case of semiconductor, there is a narrow gap between valence band and conduction band. And in case of insulators, there is a large energy gap between valence band and conduction band. So these were all the observations made here. Next, if we look at conductivity of n-type semiconductors, here the electron concentration is far greater than that of hole concentration. Therefore, sigma is equal to Ne into E into mu E plus N of H into E into mu H. As Ne is greater than Np, then we can write sigma E is equal to Ne into mu E into E. And conductivity of p-type semiconductors, if you look at here, the hole concentration is far greater than that of electron concentration. Therefore, sigma is equal to Ne into E into mu E plus Nh into E into mu H. As Np is greater than Ne, so sigma H is equal to Nh into E into mu H. So these are all the expressions related to conductivity of n-type as well as p-type semiconductors. Expression for electrical conductivity of semiconductors. So we know that current I is equal to Ne A into Vd and current density J is equal to I by A. So further, current density J is equal to Ne into Vd. So for a semiconductor, J is equal to Ne into E into Vd plus Nh into E into Vd. So consider that as equation number 1. The drift velocity Vd is equal to mu into E, and further E is equal to J by sigma. So using 1, we can write sigma is equal to Ne into E into mu E plus Nh into E into mu H. In an intrinsic semiconductor, the number of holes is equal to number of electrons, that is Ne is equal to Nh. Therefore, we can write sigma intrinsic is equal to Ne into E into mu E plus N, that is mu of holes. So here Ne is the electron concentration and Np is the hole concentration, mu E is the mobility of electrons, and further mu H is the mobility of holes. Expression for electrical, that is electron concentration, that is Ne, and hole concentration Nh at a given temperature. The number of electrons in the conduction band per unit volume of the material is called the electron concentration. Similarly, the number of holes in the valence band per unit volume of the material is called hole concentration. In general, the number of charge carriers per unit volume of the material is given by Ne is equal to 2 into 2 pi me star kT by h square root for of 3 by 2 into root for of minus of Ec minus Ef by kT. And further, Nh is equal to 2 into 2 pi mh star kT by h square root square of 3 by 2 into root square of minus Ef minus Ev by kT. So these were all the expressions related to electron and hole concentrations. Next, expression for Fermi energy level in intrinsic semiconductor. So we already know about the expression for Ne and NH. And since for intrinsic semiconductor, Ne is equal to NH, after simplifications, we are going to get, we get next slide, that is Me star by Ms star whole to the power of 2 by 3, that is 3 by 2, is equal to e to the power of minus EF plus EV plus EC minus EF by KT. And finally, after simplifications, we are going to get EF is equal to EB plus EC by 2, that is equal to EG by 2, where EG is energy gap. So, EF is equal to EG by 2 as per the expressions. Thus, the Fermi energy level is in the middle of band gap of intrinsic semiconductor. So, that is what the inference. So, EF is equal to EG by 2 in case of intrinsic semiconductor. Thank you.